Hey there! Recently, I was asked this fantastic question. Which is the better option, the E2 visa or the EB5? In this video, I compare these two fantastic US immigration options. This question, which is better, the E2 visa or the EB5, is a great question that I hear fairly often from people who want to come to the United States through an investment. And the answer to this question will depend on a number of factors, including your ability to invest, your patience, your preferred activities in the United States, and your desire for a US green card. So let's get the ball rolling by talking about the benefits of the EB5 program. The major benefit of the EB5 program is that your investment leads to a green card. But I would not say this is an easy path for most people, because your investment has to be very large and it has to create 10 full-time jobs. The minimum investment for the EB5 program is $900,000 if you invest in a project that's located in a targeted employment area, or $1.8 million if it is not in a targeted employment area. This is obviously a massive barrier to entry. Most people simply cannot come up with that amount of money. However, if you are in a position to invest that amount of money, you should really consider the EB5 program if you have a strong desire for a US green card. Now, there are two different ways that you can make an EB5 investment. The most popular way is to invest in what's called a regional center. Regional center programs basically work like this. You passively invest a large sum of money. The money is then used for large-scale real estate projects like condos, hotels, or nursing home facilities. Now, if everything goes flawlessly, your passive investment creates 10 full-time jobs, you ultimately get a green card, and a modest return on your investment. Now, you can also directly invest this amount of money in your own business, but the reason why regional center programs are favored is because they can count indirect job creation. If you invest in your own business, you will have to directly create 10 full-time jobs. So that sounds pretty amazing, right? In an ideal scenario, you make this passive investment, the investment creates 10 full-time jobs, you get a green card, and you get your money back. The problem is, one, the amount of money that's required is large, and two, it takes a long time to get a green card. The current wait times are staggering. Now, that's partially due to the pandemic that we're coming out of, but even during the best of times, the adjudication times can be very long and very difficult to deal with. So let's compare that with the E2 visa. Here are the major perks of the E2 visa. First of all, the process for obtaining it is generally much, much faster. If you are applying for the E2 visa from within the United States, you can get it in 15 days after making your application, assuming that you paid for premium processing. And if you're outside of the United States, during normal times, you can typically get an E2 visa interview within a few months. But here are the biggest downsides of the E2 visa. First of all, you have to be from a country that has an E2 treaty with the United States in order to be able to apply. Also, the E2 visa does not lead directly to a green card. So this is sort of how I look at this question, E2 visa versus EB5. If you have a strong desire for a green card and you have a lot of patience and a lot of money to invest, then by all means, look into the EB5 program. However, if you're an entrepreneur who wants to run your own business, you are from a country that has an E2 treaty with the United States, and you're okay with the fact that there's no direct path to a US green card, then I think that the E2 visa will probably be the better option. I hope this information was helpful. If you would like to learn more about these options, then I would encourage you to reach out to one of the many amazing US immigration lawyers out there. And if you did enjoy this video, please like it or share it with someone who could benefit from it. Thank you so much for your time.